Hello, this is Professor Collins. I'm going to go through a tutorial today of how to use the windy.com website when it comes to this class. So we'll see this screen every time we begin class, and windy.com has a lot of different weather data that you can access. So when you go to the homepage, it'll find the closest station to where you live based on your IP address. So for me, it's coming up as Tacoma Park. It says right now that it's 88 degrees. You see that in the top left corner, and that's in degrees Fahrenheit. It has a four day mini forecast for you, including the wind speed in different colors. Brighter colors mean a higher wind speed. It has the high temperature for those days, the expected weather for those days, including any precip with tiny raindrops at the bottom. I found this very helpful. So what we start class with is weather radar. That's what it's set on right now. So when I do this, like, let's see if we can find something interesting. So you can click 12 hours at the bottom, and it will load the past 12 hours of radar data for you. If I hit play, right now it's on rabbit speed, so that's going to be really fast. And let's just leave it as is, centered over Washington, D.C. We can see some weather kind of happening down to our south, and we can see those thunderstorms that kind of moved through last night into this morning. So looks like we got a little circulation happening here, but otherwise you can see the current radar picture. So if I pause that, now I want to transition to satellite. So satellite image, I go to the right hand column. It says radar and satellite. Under that, I click satellite, and it's going to switch data for you. And remember that visible is only during the day. Just for the sake of this demonstration, in case you are watching it at night, I'm going to change to infrared plus, which gives you colors. Okay. And I'm going to zoom out because it looks like we have something to our south right now. All right. Again, I'm going to go to the, let's do the past 6 hours. It'll be a little faster. And I'm going to hit play. It will reload all of the data for the past 6 hours. Hopefully, gotta give it a few minutes here to load. Maybe. There it goes. So obviously off the coast of Charleston, South Carolina, there is a weather system. I am unsure if this has been named at this point, but it looks like it could be a developing tropical storm. It is still trying to load. There it goes. Okay, so we can see, yeah, there's kind of a boundary here. So it seems to be having a little bit of problems loading. Let me just try a refresh here. Okay, so this takes us back to the satellite. 2 hours on the page here. Again, this is back to visible. So now I'm going to show you the wind. So let's go to the wind. And this one's pretty cool because it also incorporates a forecast. So I have wind data here. You can see the higher colors, like green and yellow, give you higher wind speeds. And then if I hit the play button in the bottom left corner, let's see if I can do it, then it gives you the forecast of the wind speed for the next few days. It looks like over the next week or so. So this is now Thursday morning, and you can see, you can watch your weather systems moving. So there's that thing off of the coast of South Carolina, North Carolina, moving northeast. You see that it's probably going to give us some weather going into this week. There's another system out here. Obviously a lot of high pressure under here, which you'll learn about in class, but high pressure under here And so it just continues forward. You can see these are calm winds now in the blues and purples. And these are high speed winds. So obviously a lot of weather associated with this one as opposed to the blue areas. So that is WIMP. All right, let's try the rain and thundercast. So they have a rain accumulation. So this shows you where it has been raining and where it will be raining according to their forecast. So let's just do the next 24 hours. Let's see if there's any rain in our forecast. I'm going to zoom in at this point. That's just a double click. Okay, and we can see that system to ourselves. So yeah, in the next 24 hours, it looks like there could be some scattered showers. And then if I go to the next 3 days, I know for a fact that rain is expected on Friday. So that's within the next 3 days. There we see that pop up. So that's another feature that they have. And we're not going to see any snow because it's July when I'm recording this. But I'd like to take a look at the thunderstorm forecast. Okay, so as this is pointed to Saturday, I'm going to drag it back to Friday evening. Let's see if I can get to something exciting. Yeah, okay, so there's exciting. 2 p.m. on Friday, there's a lot of potential activity for thunderstorms to our west, moving into our area, depending on where that system sits. And then if I go to temperature, aha. So temperature also overlays the wind, streamlines. It doesn't really give you what the value is per se. So this coloring is only the temperature. So if I zoom out, for example, because we're under a heat wave, so everything is hot right now. But if I zoom out way far out, okay, so here's North America. You can see that over here, there's some cooler temperatures, cooler being like in the 70s. And then obviously in the mountain areas, it's going to be cooler. But yeah, so a lot of, wow, that's interesting. But yes, a lot of heat happening with our heat wave this week. And then humidity is going to be how moist it is in the air. You'll learn more about that in class. So at 2 p.m. on Friday, again, this is a forecast bar. You can see that it is very moist in our area. And what else was I going to show you? Oh, okay, going back to temperature, you can also move to a position aloft. So when you're studying the atmosphere, you'll learn that there's surface weather, which is what we experience, and then there's also weather above us. So if I go up to about, let's see, I'm going to go to 500. Let's see, 500, there we are. 500 hectopascals, or millibars is what we use in class, shows you the temperature, and obviously lots cooler when you get halfway through the atmosphere. Temperature decreases with height, so we see that there's a major difference between the surface and aloft. So that's pretty cool. I'm going to put it back at the surface for our next plot. Okay, let's look at clouds. So this is forecasted clouds. This is not necessarily actual clouds. So this is forecasted clouds for Friday at 2 p.m. Just see, I'm going to zoom back in here. I'm double clicking. Let's see where it thinks those thunderstorms are going to be. Let me drag it down to like, let's see, 4 p.m. Okay, so it looks like a lot of thunderstorm activity on the eastern shore. But let's check out low clouds. Nope. So these are going to be low clouds, it says. Also has waves. So this is wave height in the ocean. Yep, there's little waves there. I like the little animation. So you can see it kind of coming on shore here. If you're into surfing, it has swells. It also has sea surface temperature. That's going to be important when it comes to our hurricanes. So zooming back out, let's see the warmest sea surface temperature we have right now. Notice that the land is blocked out. That's normal. That's because this is a land mask. So it masks everything that's land. Everything that's not land is going to have an ocean temperature. So you can actually see, these are currents in the ocean. This is not wind. So this is ocean currents. That is the Gulf. Gulf Stream right there. So you can see it coming from the Gulf, going up the eastern seaboard. That's normal. Don't worry about it. Looks like we got some 80s, maybe 90s down here. So good temperatures for the hurricanes to get started. There's also air quality. So if I click, let's go with NO2. This is satellite based. So obviously in the in the cities, there's going to be a higher amount of NO2 because that comes from cars and buses, etc. All right, and then there's a couple other kind of categories you can look at. There's snow depth for when we're in the wintertime right here. Precip type, again, that gets into the wintertime. There's dew point, so if you want to be more precise, we can turn off humidity. We're going to look at the dew point. Let's turn it on, and then it appears over here. Turn that one off so I don't get confused. So that is our dew point. So, holy cow. Our dew point. Let me double check. Yeah, our dew points are quite high. So that's sticky. That's going to be uncomfortable. Then it has different layers of clouds, freezing altitude, fog, waves, cape index. That's for severe weather. We don't really get into that in this class, but if you're interested, maybe outside of class, you can look into that. Also, there's currents. So let's turn currents on. It has a little boat. Let's see if I can find the boat. There it goes. Okay, so now we can see where the ocean currents are moving. So again, that's the Gulf Stream right there. Very, very obvious. A lot of little eddies happening as well. That's kind of interesting. What else is in here that I could show you? Let's try the extreme forecast. That sounds fun. Yeah, so it says unusually calm. It's not predicting anything crazy for us. Let's go with, that's for wind. Let's try rain on Friday, because like I said, I know Friday's going to be an active weather day. Yeah, it's saying more precip on the eastern shore, so. Also, we have pressure, so pressure is important. Let me look at weather warnings real quick. Yeah, not really much happening. So, there we have, like, a thunderstorm, extreme, okay. Let's go back to pressure, because pressure is important for us in weather. So if I put pressure, it looks like a little, like, speedometer kind of thing happening. This is going to be lower pressure. It's giving it to us in inches of mercury. I should be able to change that. You can throw on some isobars. Now we can see where the low pressure is. And it also gives you a choice of different forecast models, because this is for Friday. So if I look at the NAM, North American model, it has a little bit further inland, interesting, as opposed to the European model. So yeah, so we have different different layers with the Windy website, and you will become more familiar with this. We use this for, if nothing else, radar almost all the time. You can also make a login for yourself, and you can save your settings, like if you want it to be in. Oh, I forgot to tell you. So you probably can't hear this, but when you turn on the radar, it has like a little popping sound it makes when there's lightning, because it has lightning data. That's the little flashes you're seeing. So that's kind of a cool little like aesthetic thing that they've made for this website. So again, you can log in, you can save your settings. You can search different locations. It goes all over the world. Very interesting and useful for homework assignments. Hope you'd enjoy.